Hello, today's parable is the parable of the Good Samaritan, arguably the most well-known parable in the Bible. If you aren't a Christian, you've definitely heard the term, the phrase Good Samaritan before. This comes straight from Luke chapter 10, verses 30 through 37. So the context of this is there's an expert in the law who stood up to test Jesus, and he's like, what must I do to inherit eternal life? And Jesus says, love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, strength, and mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. And the expert in the law is like, "What? Who is my neighbor?" Right, and this is where the parable begins in verse 30. And Jesus is saying there's a man who's going down from Jerusalem to Jericho, and he's attacked by robbers, and he's left half dead. And a priest and a Levite come past him and don't have pity on him, don't help that half dead man. But a Samaritan, he came by, he took pity on him, and he bandaged his wounds, he took him to an innkeeper, paid the innkeeper to take care of him while he left, and he's like, you know, I'll reimburse you for any extra funds and extra expenses that you have. When I return. And Jesus asks this expert in the law in verse 36, which of these three do you think was the neighbor to the man who fell into the hands of robbers? The expert in the law replied, the one who had mercy on him. Jesus told him, go and do likewise. So this expert in the law initially wanting to test Jesus gets absolutely demolished, destroyed by Jesus's parable here of the Good Samaritan, and is saying, this is your neighbor. This, even a Samaritan person can be your neighbor. The expert in the law, obviously a Jew, sees the priest and the Levite people from the church obviously pass up this wounded man. But the Jews do not have a good relationship with the Samaritans as a result of a division happening that happened hundreds of years before. And he's saying even this person is to be your neighbor. You know, to admit that a Samaritan was a true neighbor to this man, not a fellow Jew, would have been hard to hear for a lawyer. And that's the point. It furthers the point that this is your neighbor. Anyone is capable of being your neighbor. Everyone is capable of being your neighbor. And we are responsible for being a neighbor to everyone as well. So that is the answer to the second part of this part from Deuteronomy. Love your neighbor as yourself. That is our neighbor.